The NeoSuccess Project is part of the Horizon 2020 programme, a European programme which aims to develop innovative technologies by funding them. Such is the case of NeoSuccess, a project whose goal is to fast-track a new technology by developing it from lab scale to industrial and commercial scale. This is achieved by running lab and pilot scale experiments, designing the industrial scale unit, building and validating the unit, to ultimately run several experiments aiming to demonstrate the viability of the process at this scale. Currently, the succinic acid and biomethane production are separate industrial processes. NeoSuccess is the first technology worldwide that recycles and uses residual waste streams to simultaneously produce these two high-value added products. The NeoSuccess technology relies on two main strong innovations. A. Integrates biogas, upgrading with fermentation-based succinic acid production. B. Uses agro-industrial waste streams as sugar sources to produce succinic. The implementation of this breakthrough and patented technology can easily be translated into sustainable solutions to cover biogas plants' needs, which are related to the growing demand for energy and fuels with a low carbon footprint. Succinic acid is a high-value, multifunctional platform chemical with numerous applications including cosmetics, bioplastics and pharmaceutical industries. The global succinic market size was valued in 2021 at around $225 million. Nonetheless, a high percentage of its production is still petroleum-based. Biogas is a mixture of 60% CH4 and 40% CO2, along with other trace gases. The aim is to remove the CO2 in order to obtain a gas with a CH4 concentration higher than 95%. Thus, the resulting biomethane can be injected into the natural gas grid or directly used as fuel. The global biomethane market size was valued in 2021 at $6 billion. The NeoSuccess technology is carried out by a wild-type bacteria, Actinobacillus succinogenes 130Z. It has its origins in the bovine rumen, and it naturally produces high amounts of succinic acid under the right conditions by metabolizing a wide range of sugars. This makes Actinobacillus ideal for the valorization of sugar waste. The upstream unit is operated using sugary waste as the carbon source, while biogas is continuously sparged through. Fixation of CO2 is achieved through gas recycling to improve its transfer into the broth. After 2 days, succinic has been accumulated in the broth, while biogas is continuously upgraded to biomethane. The succinic acid coming from USP is purified in the downstream process, DSP. In the DSP, first excess biomass and acids are removed, then succinic acid is crystallized. The first steps consist of a centrifuge followed by a filtration and nanofiltration unit to remove unwanted solids. The second part consists of a spray dryer, where a pulverization process is carried out in a stream of hot air, which dehydrates the product, obtaining succinic acid powder particles.
A consortium for the project was made, which is formed by 4 members in this case. 2 of them are universities, 1 from Denmark and 1 from Greece, and 2 engineering companies, both of them from Spain. So in this case, here's where Even comes in, and let's say that the role of the engineering companies is to take this process that was discovered in the lab scale or in the laboratories of Denmark and bring it to an industrial reality. In the case of Even, we coordinate the project as well as designing and constructing and operating the industrial unit.
The role of AUTH is to provide the know-how and to support with the monitoring and the knowledge in to the whole process from the start to the end, from the production of the succinic acid until its separation for its commercial use at the end.
The role of DTU in the NeoSuccess project is as technology provider, so we carried out many of the research and development tasks included in the project. So this included different tasks such as waste characterization for characterizing the waste that is going to be used in the NeoSuccess technology, as well as evaluating the process performance and developing optimization and control protocols for the operation of the process.
Norbento participa en el proyecto NeosAccess como ingeniería especializada en el sector del biogás. Nuestro principal interés en este proyecto reside en la posibilidad de poder ofrecer a los clientes potenciales un sistema de upgrading eficiente y de coste reducido con respecto a las alternativas que existen en el mercado. En concreto, además del modelo de negocio, hemos desarrollado la unidad de downstream a partir de la cual se puede concentrar el ácido succínico hasta niveles comerciales a partir de los procesos anteriores que se desarrollan en el pilotaje.
The importance of the project is most clearly evidenced by its contribution to several sustainable development goals. On the one hand, wastewater from a food industry is being treated, valorizing it. Furthermore, an energy source, such as biomethane, comes out as a result of the process. On the other hand, it correlates directly to the contribution of generating sustainable and innovative technologies for the future. Last, but not least, by adding value to a residue from a food production cycle, we are closing it, thus giving it a more responsible approach to this production.